Okay, now to the shocking story of Kate Spade. The husband of the fashion designer, Kate Spade, is breaking his silence after his wife's sudden and shocking death. So we want to read Andy Spade's statement in full. It's long, but we think it's important. So here it is. Kate was the most beautiful woman in the world. She was the kindest person I've ever known and my best friend for 35 years. My daughter and I are devastated by her loss and can't even begin to fathom life without her. We are deeply heartbroken and miss her already. Kate suffered from depression and anxiety for many years. She was actively seeking help and working closely with her doctors to treat her disease, one that takes far too many lives. We were in touch with her the night before, and she sounded happy. There was no indication and no warning that she would do this. It was a complete shock, and it clearly was not her. There were personal demons that she was battling. For the past 10 months, we had been living separately, but within a few blocks of each other. Bea, their daughter, was living with both of us, and we saw each other or spoke every day. We ate many meals together as a family and continued to vacation together as a family. Our daughter was our priority. We were not legally separated and never even discussed divorce. We were best friends, trying to work through our problems in the best way we knew how. We were together for 35 years. We loved each other very much and simply needed a break. This is the truth. Anything else that is out there right now is false. She was actively seeking help for depression and anxiety over the last 5 years, seeing a doctor on a regular basis and taking medication for both depression and anxiety. There was no substance or alcohol abuse. There were no business problems. We loved creating our business together. We were co-parenting our beautiful daughter. I have yet to see any note left behind and am appalled that a private message to my daughter has been so heartlessly shared with the media. My main concern is B and protecting her privacy as she deals with the unimaginable grief of losing her mother. Kate loved B so very much. Joining us now is Dr. Jody Gold. She's a psychiatrist and the director of the Gold Center for Mind, Health, and Wellness. Dr. Gold, what a tragedy. How sad to hear that note. I mean, so shocking, primarily for me, to hear that there were no warning signs and it was sudden and they had talked to her the night before and heard that she was happy. That sends a shiver down my spine because obviously we all know people who are struggling at some points. Yeah. How can there be no warning signs?
Well, I suspect that there were warning signs. There may not have been warning signs the night before. We do know that she was struggling with anxiety and depression. And I'm really glad that the husband came out with the statement. It's so heartfelt, and it actually really does help to clarify things and help us to understand that she was struggling with anxiety and depression for a long time.
Also, because there are rumors, of course, circulating. Yes. Anytime something like this happens when it's so sudden, there are rumors, and we do have reporting that there was a note left behind that referenced her daughter and her husband, but we haven't revealed the contents of that note because, again, we need the context of what she was going through and what her husband knows about this. So I appreciate that he was saying that her daughter obviously needs privacy during this time. But when you heard about this, and now that you know this information, what do you think was going on with Kate Spade?
Well, she was clearly suffering from anxiety and depression, and it's always a shock when someone kills themselves. What I'm so struck is that we talk about tragedy all the time here. You talk about it all the time. But this has really sparked a worldwide discussion about depression and suicide, and I've been trying to understand why so much. And I think it's partly because she doesn't fit the bill of who we think actually usually kills themselves. I mean, she was glamorous and successful and on social media and beautiful, and yet she still suffered with anxiety and depression. So I think that's part of why there's so much of a discussion about it, is that we don't feel like she fits the bill. And the truth is that depression affects almost 7% of our population. Everybody out there has either suffered from depression or knows someone that has. So it's quite real, and it affects everybody.
Oh, for sure. I mean, we have some stats on mental illness. Yeah. Women suffer from mental illness, 21%, men 14%. So it's more, more female related to have some of these struggles.
Yes, it's more depression's more common in women than in men, but it's quite prevalent. And so the risk factors for suicide are often more common in men than in women. But it's a huge problem, and so suicide's real. And talking about it can raise risk factors.
More women have received mental health treatment than men. 48% of women 33% of men. And I think that that's another one of the problems here, which is it sounds like she and the family were doing everything right. She was in treatment. She was being medicated.
Yep.
She was talking to someone on a regular basis. And then the idea that in a split second or for however long she was contemplating it, this happens. I mean, what is the answer if those things don't work?
Well, the answer, I mean, it's a really serious mental illness, and I think what I would want her daughter to understand is that she suffered from a serious mental illness. She clearly got treatment. She clearly tried to fight it, and she lost the battle. And for people out there suffering from depression, they don't have to lose the battle. There is help out there. And as friends and family, we do have to look for risk factors and signs. It sounds like her husband's struggling with the fact that they didn't see the signs.
And what are those?
The signs would be changes in behavior, withdrawing. Social media is a big one. If you notice that a friend or family member is talking about suicide, talking about death, or even just looks strange, is doing something different on social media, you should reach out to them.
I mean, I think the other message for people who are struggling with depression, and again, so many people are, is that it can pass. You know, when you're in it, you think that that cloud will be over you forever. But then you can turn a corner, and it does pass, and that cloud does lift. But it's hard to wait for that sometimes.
It's such an insidious illness because one of the symptoms of depression is hopelessness. So when you're talking to someone who's depressed, they will tell you there's no hope. They might as well kill themselves. But the truth is it passes. That's why you have to call hotlines. That's why you have to reach out to friends. And what I would really tell people out there is if you have a friend or family member that you're worried about, don't be afraid to ask them. Don't be afraid to ask if they're depressed. And don't even be afraid to say, hey, are you thinking about killing yourself?
Should you do that?
Yes. People don't do it enough.
And if someone says, yes, I actually have considered that, then what do you do?
Then it's time probably to step it up. It's time to be there for them and to help them get more support. But if you don't ask, you don't know. And people are really afraid to ask.
But can you alert their therapist? I mean, can you, if somebody is contemplating suicide and you know that, then can you have them committed, for lack of a better word, because they're a danger to themselves? Can you do something really aggressive for that person?
Well, I don't know if the goal is to initially get them committed, but what you can do, and you're allowed to do that, is to let people know. You can let a therapist know. You can let a doctor know. The way confidentiality works is that the therapist or the doctor may not be able to speak to you, but you can call anybody's therapist or doctor, pick up the phone and say, I just want to give you information, or I'm really concerned about my friend or my husband or my wife. You can always let people know. There are suicide prevention hotlines. There's even crisis mobile units that will come to your home if you're worried.
That is really good advice. People need to not just sort of try to respect the person's privacy, which I think we're all inclined to do, but to be aggressive and to get involved.
Yeah. Don't respect their privacy. This is the moment where privacy isn't so important. This is the moment where you need to reach out, and they need to know there's people caring about them, and at least you know there's another side, and get them the help they need.